Big cook, little cook, welcome to our cafe. Big cook, little cook, want you to come and play. Meeting all the friends we cook for, sharing stories, trips and fun. Big cook, little cook, we'll cook for everyone. Hello. Welcome to our cafe, the best cafe in the world. Today is a very special day because I've been sent a present by my Auntie Betty. Now, where is it? Hey, can you see where it is? What, over here? It's not there. Where? What, over here? Oh, it's not there either. Oh, now, where can it be? Fooled you! Oh, very funny, Small. Hello! Right, let's see what Auntie Betty sent. Open up the box. Here we are. Lift off the lid. Oh, look! Auntie Betty sent me a woolly jumper. Hey! It's made out of wool, and wool comes from sheep. See it on, shall we? Oh, yes.
It must have taken ages for Auntie Betty to knit that.
Hoo-hoo! It's lovely! Hey! Now, where's a mirror so I can see it on? Oh, the cooker.
Oh, that looks great on you, Ben.
Oh, no. I can't see anything in there. Where's that mirror? It was here somewhere. No, not in there. Where could it be, Small?
Ben! Oh, Ben!
I'm sure I've left it somewhere. What about round here?
It's Auntie Betty's jumper. It's...
Hey, yeah, it's fantastic, isn't it? Oh, oh, no! Oh, dear, oh, it's all unravelling, Small. Oh, poor Auntie Betty. What am I going to do? Oh! Oh, we've got a customer, Small. You better go and see who it is, and I'll try and sort this jumper out. What am I going to tell Auntie Betty?
I'm on my way! Woo!
Who's our customer, Small?
I'll give you a clue. It's someone who's lost something. Well, lots of things, actually. Things that go... Bah! Sheep! Someone who's lost her sheep. And that person is Little Bo Peep.
Really? Little Bo Peep's come to our cafe?
Oh, yes!
I bet she's hungry, though, Small. So what are we going to cook for Little Bo Peep who's lost her sheep?
I think it's time to look in my book!
We need a story to help us cook.
Let's take a look in Little Cook's book. Little Cook's Adventures in the Big World. Let me see.
One day, Little Bo Peep was sitting alone knitting.
Hello, Little Bo Peep, I said. What are you knitting?
Oh, said Little Bo Peep sadly. I'm just knitting. You see, I'm feeling very, very sad because I've lost all my sheep.
Why don't we try calling your sheep? I said. Maybe they'll come back if you call them.
Oh, I've tried that, sniffed Little Bo Peep. Listen. Come back! Come back, sheep! Come back!
Oh, it was the loudest shouting I had ever heard. It made me cover my ears. No wonder the sheep weren't coming back. Little Bo Peep, I said, I think I've got a better idea. Maybe your sheep don't like shouting, I said. Maybe they like singing.
Oh, yes,
said Little Bo Peep. And so I played the guitar. And Little Bo Peep sang along. Sheep, 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 sheep. It was an awful racket. I had another think, and then I said, why don't we try this? Little Bo Peep has lost her sheep. She doesn't know where to find them. Sing them a song, they'll come along, wagging their tails behind them. And the sheep came back. They liked the song Little Bo Peep and I were singing so much that they were back in no time. Little Cook to the rescue once again!
That was a great adventure.
You're right, Small, but we still don't know what to make for Bo Peep to eat.
Way! Time for some serious thinking, Ben.
That's right. What does someone who's lost their sheep want for a tasty snack?
I know! Big Cook's Big Cookery Book!
Of course, the Big Cookery Book. There's recipes for everything in there.
And where do we look for things to cook?
In the book, in the book, in Big Cook's book. Yes, here it is. The very thing for Little Bo Peep.
A potato sheep. We turn a potato into a sheep. What a clever idea.
Come on then, Small. You read out the ingredients and I'll see if we've got them.
OK, let's see. We're going to need olives.
OK, in the cupboard. Here we are. Olives, got them, Small.
A baking potato.
Oh, in the fridge. One potato, got it.
Cheese.
Oh, yes, lovely cheese. Oh.
And thick yoghurt.
Yoghurt, yoghurt. Oh, don't seem to have any of that. Right. There we are. Everything we need for the recipe, apart from the yoghurt.
Well, don't worry, Ben. I'll just whiz off and get some. Woohoo!
Righto, and I'll get everything ready.
Hey, why don't you come along too? Way!
Go, Small, go, Small, whiz away! I wonder what he'll see today.
Oh, what a lovely day!
These sheep are in a hurry. What are they up to? The farmer is attaching some pipes to the sheep so they can be milked. That's the sheep's milk. Mmm, delicious. This milk is going to be used to make yogurt. First of all, the milk has to be heated up and stirred in this machine. Then it has to be cooled down again. Before the yogurt can be eaten, it has to be poured into pots and left in the fridge for a while. A pot of delicious yogurt made from sheep's milk.
Better get back to the cafe. Bye. Way! I'm back.
Did you get the yogurt?
I certainly did.
Wow!
It was brilliant, Ben. I saw how sheep's yogurt is made. And I even met a few sheep as well. Any sign of Little Bo Peep sheep?
Nope, still lost. We better make her a tasty snack to cheer her up. We're all ready, so take a look.
And we will show you how to cook.
Jelly boats and pirates, gold princess pea pies, carrot cakes and fruity smiles,
and envelope surprise.
We love our cafe and we love to cook. We have a fantastic recipe book. He is Big Cook and he is Small. Friends in our cafe, we cook for them all.
When your tummy gets all rumbly, you're for a treat. You can make something delicious to eat.
Have you cleaned the surfaces?
Yes. Have you washed your hands?
Yes.
All clean and ready to cook.
Do you remember the ingredients to Bo Peep's sheep?
You do?
There were olives.
Two. Chopped up.
A baking potato.
One.
Cheese.
One cup. Grated.
And thick yogurt.
Three teaspoons.
Whoopee! Let's get started!
The first thing to do is put the potato onto a greased baking tray. There we are. And then I'm going to prick it with a fork. There we go. And again, turn it over. And one there. And another one there. This'll help it to cook. And then let's put it in the oven. So, oven gloves on. Over we go. Just leave that there. Open the oven. And in it goes. Great. And I'm going to set the oven to 230 degrees Celsius, gas mark 8. And make sure you get your grown-up helper to do this bit for you, because the oven is hot, hot, hot.
Keep it in the oven for 45 minutes. I'll set the timer. There we go. 45. Ready!
Take out the potato.
Great! Let's turn it into a sheep.
Not yet, Small. We've got to let it cool down first. Just enough so we can touch it with our fingers without getting burnt.
Okay, okay. We won't turn it into a sheep yet. We'll wait.
Sheep? Wool?
Oh, jumpers! What am I going to do about my jumper, Small? What am I going to tell Auntie Betty? Oh, dear. Oh, don't worry, Ben. We'll sort it out later. Has the potato cooled yet?
Let's see. Yes, it has, Small. It's cool enough to touch.
Hooray! Now let's turn it into a sheep.
I've cut the potato in half. There we are. And I'm going to scoop out the fluffy potato. Nice and soft. Careful. Out it comes. Pop it into a bowl. There we are.
Hee-hee! It's fluffy, just like a fluffy sheep.
Yes, it is, Small. So, all the potato into the bowl. And I'm going to add some of the grated cheese. In it goes. Little bit more. There we go. I've put in most of it there. And finally, I'm going to add 2 teaspoons of the yogurt. 1 and 2. And then mix it all up together.
Ben, what happened to the rest of the potato? The brown crispy bits on the outside.
The potato skins? They're here, Small.
They're very important, those bits, aren't they, Ben?
Yes, they are. Because I'm now going to spoon the fluffy, yoghurty, cheesy mixture back into the potato skins. So, spoonful into this one. A little bit more. There we go. Fill it up. And then to do the other one. In it goes. Back in the skin. In you go. And I think one more little spoonful. Pop that there. And finally, I'm going to add the rest of the grated cheese. Sprinkle it over. Oh, yes, very nice.
And now it's time to put it back in the oven for 15 minutes.
Yes, it is, Small. So, oven gloves out. Pop the potatoes onto a baking tray. And take them back over to the oven. Here we are. Pop them there. And make sure you get your grown-up helper to do this bit for you, because remember, the oven is hot, hot, hot.
I'll set the timer. For 15 minutes. Finished. minutes, all done.
And all lovely and golden.
It doesn't look that much like a sheep, but that's what we do next.
So, I'm going to pop this potato onto a plate. There we go. And now, I'm going to take one more blob of yoghurt and pop it on. There we are. This is going to be the sheep's face.
Remember the olives? Well, here's where you find out what we do with them. They're going to be used for the sheep's eyes.
Hee-hee! One there, and another one there. Let's give her some ears as well. There we go. Pop another one round here. And not to forget the sheep's legs at the bottom. There we go, two there. And another two up the front. Ooh, she looks great. Ha!
You mean,
And I'm just going to finish her off with a few sprigs of parsley. There.
Let's get it off to little Bo Peep.
One Bo Peep sheep coming through. There. All done.
So what do we do now? Can we play?
Not yet. Time to clean and put away.
Hooray!
Wash, wipe, scrub and clean. Make the kitchen sparkle and gleam. My name's Ben.
And my name's Small.
We've got the cleanest kitchen of all. Tidy all the bits and bobs, the things that help us do our job. Ingredients we'll put away, ready for use another day. Pots and pans will start to smell if we don't wash them really well. And now it's clear, let's all smile, we'll be finished in a little while. All around, up and down, we've got the cleanest cafe in town.
Aha, here comes the plate.
Oh, and it looks like Bo Peep's enjoyed her potato sheep. And look, Small, she's left a note.
Well, what does it say? What does it say?
Let's see, shall we? Oh, it says, Dear Big Cook Ben and Little Cook Small, thank you for my Bo Peep sheep. It was delicious. Hoo-hoo. Here's two presents for you both to say thank you, Big Cook and Little Cook. Oh, what could it be? Oh, look, Small. It's another woolly jumper. And it's just like the one that Auntie Betty gave me.
Now you won't have to tell her about what happened to the first one.
Hooray! Oh, and look, Small. There's something else in here for you.
A little Bo Peep hat just for me.
Ha-ha! Here you go, Small.
Thanks, Ben. Hee-hee! What do you think?
Woohoo! Ha ha! Aww!
Don't you mean?
Bah!
See you soon!
See you soon!
Bye!
Bye! Bye.
Big cook, little cook, welcome to our cafe. Big cook, little cook, want you to come and play.
Hello, welcome to our cafe, the best cafe in the world. Today we're making, what are we making, Ben?
Hello, everyone. Today we're making a wedding cake for Walter and Wendy, who live on the high street. They're getting married.
It is lovely, Ben, but a wedding cake needs to look really, really special.
What's wrong with it?
There's nothing wrong with it, Ben. It's just it's not very interesting, is it?
No.
There needs to be something on it. Some decoration.
Oh, yes. That's because it's not finished yet. Not until I put this on it.
What on earth is that?
It's a digger. Good, isn't it?
We can't have a digger on Walter and Wendy's wedding cake.
No?
No, it's got nothing to do with a wedding.
Very pretty, though.
No. Let's try something else.
Okay, oh, yeah. What about this?
What do you think? It needs to be something pretty. Try something else, Ben.
Pretty, pretty. Oh, yes. Okay. What about this?
No, Ben.
It still isn't finished, and now we've got a customer. I'll have to put the cake away. But we'll still have to think of something to put on it, because Walter and Wendy are coming to pick the cake up today.
I'm on my way! Woo!
Who is it, Small? Who's our customer?
She's very beautiful, Ben.
Very beautiful? I can't guess from very beautiful. I need a better clue.
Okay, then. She's got seven friends.
Seven friends? Oh, it's Snow White. Oh, Snow White in our cafe.
Yes, it is, Ben. Snow White. She's very pretty.
Oh, I love the story of Snow White and the seven dwarfs.
Me too, Ben. But there's more to that story than you think. I think it's time to look in my book.
We need a story to help us cook.
Let's take a look in Little Cook's book. Little Cook's Adventures in the Big World. Let me see.
Far away lived a beautiful princess, Snow White, and her wicked stepmother. One day, the wicked stepmother looked into her magic mirror and said,
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the fairest of them all?
And the mirror replied, Snow White. The wicked stepmother was so cross that she ordered her servant to take Snow White into the wood and leave her there. Snow White was a little frightened. Luckily, she saw a tiny house in the distance. When Snow White finally reached the house, she was very tired and went straight to sleep. To her surprise, when she woke up, she was surrounded by seven dwarves. They felt sorry for Snow White and asked her to stay. Meanwhile, their wicked stepmother looked into her mirror.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the fairest of them all?
Again, the mirror replied, Snow White. The wicked stepmother was very angry. She disguised herself as an old lady, and when she found Snow White, she gave her a poisoned apple. Poor Snow White was now under a spell and would sleep for 100 years. When the dwarves came back, they were very upset. Luckily for them, I had an idea. I dashed off to find the handsomest prince in the land and brought him back as quickly as I could. When the prince saw Snow White, he kissed her. The kiss broke the spell. Snow White awoke. She married the prince and they lived happily ever after. Little Cook to the rescue once again!
That was a great adventure.
Oh, I love a story with a happy ending.
Way! And it just shows you that true love always wins in the end.
Ah.
Look at you, Small, and you say I'm soppy. You're the one who's soppy. Soppy, soppy, sop, sop, soppy. No, I'm not. I meant, I was just thinking about the lovely meal that I cooked for them all. And we should be thinking about the meal we're going to cook.
You're quite right, Small. Now, what can we cook for Snow White?
I know! Big Cook's Big Cookery Book!
Of course, the Big Cookery Book. There's recipes for everything in there.
And where do we look for things to cook?
In the book. In Big Cook's book. Oh, yes, here it is. Nothing but the best for Snow White.
Seven dwarves pies? What's that got to do? Oh, I see. Seven dwarves. We make seven custard pies with a dwarf on each one. All right. It's a reminder of our little friends. Brilliant, Ben.
Come on then, Small. You read out the ingredients and I'll see if we've got them.
Okay, let's see. An apple.
Apple, okay. Here we go. Got the apple, Small.
An egg?
In the fridge, here we go. Egg, got the egg.
Milk?
Milk in here. Milk, yep.
Short crust pastry?
Oh, yes, pastry, there it is. Got the pastry.
And custard.
Right, custard. Ooh. Oh no, cupboard's bare. Oh, we haven't got any custard, Small. We've got everything else for the recipe. But how can we make seven dwarves pies without custard?
Don't worry, Ben. That's a job for Little Cook Small and his magic spoon. Woohoo! I'll go and get some custard.
Hope you don't bring back some mustard.
Up and away! Hey, why don't you come along too? Way!
Go, Small, whiz away! I wonder what he'll see today.
Oh, I'm so excited!
This is a big factory where custard is made. Wow, look at all that sugar. This man is pouring in all the ingredients that are used to make custard. Oh, mustn't forget the milk. Do you remember where milk comes from? Milk comes from cows. Now the custard is mixed up in all these pipes. Ooh, let's see where that man's going. I think he's going to look at the custard. Oh yes, it looks good to me. It's nice and yellow, and there's lots of it. I love custard on my apple pie. These pots are going to be filled with custard. There it is! Lovely, delicious custard. On go the lids. And now they're ready to be delivered to the shops.
That was great! I can't wait to tell Ben about this. Bye! Way! I'm back! Here it is, one carton of freshly made custard.
Oh, lovely. Do they have enough to spare?
Oh, yes, Ben. I've never seen so much custard in all my life. Enough custard to float a boat on.
Oh, a sea of custard. Yummy.
I hope Snow White likes it.
Ah, Snow White. Come on, Small, we better get on.
You're right. We better get on, Ben.
We're all ready, so take a look.
And we will show you how to cook.
Jelly boats and pirates, gold princess pea pies, carrot cakes and fruity smiles,
and envelope surprise.
We love our cafe and we love to cook. We have a fantastic recipe book.
He is big cook and he is small.
Friends in our cafe, we cook for them all.
When your tummy
gets all rumbly,
you're ready for a treat.
You can make something delicious to eat.
Have you cleaned the surfaces?
Yes. Have you washed your hands?
Yes. All clean and ready to cook. Do you remember the ingredients to seven dwarves pies?
You do?
There was an apple.
One. Sliced.
An egg.
One.
Milk.
3 tablespoons.
Short crust pastry.
1 packet.
And custard.
1 carton.
Whoopee! Let's get started!
The first thing we need to do is turn on the oven to 180 degrees Celsius, gas mark 4. And make sure you get your grown-up helper to do that bit for you, because remember, the oven is hot, hot, hot. That's done. Now I can get on with making the pies. Can you read out the recipe for me, Small?
OK, Ben. First, sprinkle some flour onto a board and roll out the pastry.
Okie dokie. Sprinkle the flour and roll out the pastry. Here we are. We need to make it nice and flat.
I wonder if this is a magic mirror, like the one in the story. Mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the fairest of them all? Who? Ben? No! Surely it's me!
Right. Use a knife to cut round a saucer to make a circle. And make sure you get your grown-up helper to help you with this bit. Here we go. All the way around. Great. And lift it off. Oh, careful. And I'm going to make another one just next to it. Round it goes. All the way. And this side. Brilliant. Now, I'm going to pop one of them onto a greased baking tray. Up it comes. And there. And I'm going to use our sliced apple to put in the middle. There's a few more there. Great.
Now I'm going to pretend to be the prince in the story. He was very good at dancing.
Next, we mix the milk and the egg together in a bowl. In it goes. Give it a good old whisk. Mix them both up together. And I'm going to use this brush to brush the mixture around the edges of this piece of pastry. There we are, all the way around the edges. This will help the other piece of pastry stick on top.
I'd love to meet a princess. I'd have to learn to dance, though. Here goes. Oh, I'm not very good at this. I'll need some practice.
This is the clever part. I've got a little man cutter here, and I'm going to use it to make a hole in the other piece of pastry. On it goes. A bit of a twist. And let's see. Oh, there he is. And I'm going to take this piece out. Look at that. Just like a little dwarf.
Hey! I'm getting better at this. Way! Woo! What do you think? Are you dancing too?
Carefully does it. On it goes. There. Now the trick is to put one piece of pastry right on top of the other. And I'm going to take a fork and press down just around the edges. This will help it to stick. And that side. Very good. And there we have a pie with a dwarf-shaped hole in the middle. So all we need to do now is add the yummy custard. Gorgeous. A spoonful in there. There we go. And another one.
Oh. Oh no! I'm never going to meet a princess now I'm covered in custard.
Oops. Sorry, Small. Okay. Take the eggy milky mixture and brush it all over the top of the pie. This'll help it to go all brown and shiny when it cooks. I'm going to cover all the pastry. Great. And then into the oven it goes. So, oven gloves on, and over we go. And make sure you get your grown-up helper to do this bit for you, because remember, the oven is hot, hot, hot. Pop it in for 30 minutes.
I'll set the timer for 30 minutes.
They're cooked and cooled now, so I'm going to pop the last one onto a plate. There. I've made 7 of them to remind Snow White of her 7 friends. What do you think, Small?
Perfect! Snow White's going to love them.
Here we go.
Seven dwarves pies coming through. There, all done.
So what do we do now? Can we play?
Not yet. Time to clean and put away.
Hooray!
Wash, wipe, scrub and clean. Make the kitchen sparkle and gleam.
My name's Ben.
And my name's Small.
We've got the cleanest kitchen of all.
Tidy all the bits and bobs, the things that help us do our jobs.
Ingredients well put away,
ready for use another day.
Pots and pans will start to smell
if we don't wash them really well.
And now it's clear, let's all smile, we'll be finished in a little while.
All around, up and down,
we've got the cleanest cafe in town.
Aha, here comes the plate.
Oh, yes! It looks like Snow White enjoyed her seven dwarves pies. And look, Small, she's left a note.
Well, what does it say? What does it say?
Let's see, shall we? It says, Dear Big Cook Ben and Little Cook Small, my seven dwarves pies were delicious. Woo-hoo. To say thank you, I've left you one of my new bows. I thought it might be useful for your cake. Oh, of course, Small. Snow White knows all about wedding cakes because she got married to the prince at the end of the story. Let's see how it looks, shall we? There.
Oh, Water and Wendy's wedding cake looks perfect.
See you soon.
See you soon.
Big cook, little cook, welcome to our cafe. Big cook, little cook, want you to come and play. Meeting all the friends we cook for, sharing stories, trips and fun. Big cook, little cook, we'll cook for everyone.
This is going so well.
Have you put the cards away yet, Ben?
Nearly, Small. Oh, hello, everyone. Welcome to our cafe.
The best cafe in the world! You haven't put those cards away yet, Ben.
Sorry, Small, but I was just trying to finish making my house of cards.
And you have. It looks great. It might get in the way of the cooking, though.
Oh, yes, you're right. Are you going to help me blow it down then, Small?
Okay. I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow your house down.
Hey, I know a really good game we could play with these cards, Small.
Oh, goody. Have we got time?
Of course. We don't have a customer yet, do we? Okay, Small, here's what we do. Right, I'll find a card like a four, there. So now we have to find four of something right here in the kitchen. Okay, let's see. Bowls. One, two. I can see two bowls, but not four.
Oh, I can see some spoons. How many? One, two, three, but not four.
Well, what about cups? How many cups? Look, one, two, three, four, yeah!
Oh, great, Ben. Can I pick a card this time?
Of course you can, Small. Here you go.
Thanks, Ben.
Oh, no!
What? What is it, Small?
It's a king, Ben.
A king? Ooh, that is a tricky one. I mean, there isn't a king in the kitchen, is there?
No.
But I think I'd make a great king. Yes, in fact, with this cloak on, woohee! I think I'd make a brilliant king.
No time for that now, Small. You better get your kingly cloak off. You don't want to get it caught on your spoonmobile.
Okay, I'm on my way. Woohoo!
Who's our customer today, Small?
You'll never guess who it is, Ben.
Give me a clue.
Okay, she's wearing a crown and a cloak.
Oh, a queen! A queen! Oh my, we've got a queen in our cafe. I must practice my bowing. Oh,
good morning, Mom. How very lovely to see you, Mom.
There's no time for any of that now, Ben. Let's get cooking. I think it's time to look in my book.
We need a story to help us cook.
Let's take a look in Little Cook's book. Little Cook's Adventures in the Big World. Let me see.
One day I came across a beautiful castle. This was the Castle of Hearts, and inside lived the famous Queen of Hearts, the sweetest queen in the whole wide world. I knocked at the kitchen door. The cook was inside. He was in a real tizzy. You see, the Queen of Hearts was a very fussy eater, and the poor cook couldn't find anything she liked. He wrung his hands and said to me, "I've tried sandwiches, I've tried jelly, but she won't put any of it in her belly. I've tried apples, juicy and scrummy, but even apples won't go in her tummy. I've tried vegetables, I've tried meat, but I can't find anything the Queen will eat." Well, as you can imagine, I had to go to her rescue. I found the Queen of Hearts in the garden. "Hello, Your Majesty," I said. "I'm your new cook for today."
"Oh dear," she replied. "That's a dreadful job because I'm very fussy about food. You'll never find anything I like."
"What about these lovely strawberries?" I asked. The strawberries looked juicy and plump and ripe. The Queen tried one and...
"Ugh!" she cried. "It's too sour. Everything's too sour for me. I'm a sweet person and I need sweet things."
And it was then that I had one of my brilliant ideas. I took the strawberries away and I made them into jam. Lovely sweet strawberry jam. I made jam sandwiches, and when the Queen tasted one, she said,
"Delicious!"
And from that day on, the Queen of Hearts put jam on everything. On toast, on sausages, even on cabbage. Sometimes she accidentally put it on herself.
"Look at me!" she'd cry. "I'm so jammy!"
Little Cook to the rescue once again!
That was a great adventure.
Oh, yes, and I think it's given us a big clue about what to make for the Queen of Hearts, don't you?
Way! Maybe we could cook her something with jam.
Oh, yes, but what? I wonder.
Oh, yeah. Oh. I know, Big Cook's Big Cookery Book.
Of course, the Big Cookery Book. There's recipes for everything in there.
And where do we look for things to cook?
In the book, in Big Cook's book. Here we are, Small. The perfect thing. Queen of Hearts tarts. The Queen of Hearts made some tarts all on a summer's day. The Knave of Hearts stole those tarts and took them clean away.
Oh, well, that settles it. The Queen of Hearts loves jam tarts.
Yes, she does, Small, and it's all thanks to you. After all, you introduced her to jam.
Oh, that was nothing, Ben.
And I think we should make her some more right away. After all, that naughty knave did steal hers.
That's right, Ben. I'll read out the ingredients.
And I'll see if we've got them.
OK, we're going to need shortcrust pastry.
OK, over to the fridge. Here we go, yep, shortcrust pastry, got it, Small.
And strawberry jam.
Strawberry jam. Here we are. Okay then, Small, we've got the shortcrust pastry, but the strawberry jam is a problem.
How can strawberry jam be a problem?
Because we haven't got any.
Oh, well, don't worry, Ben. I'll whiz off and get some. Only the best for our queen.
Good idea, Small, and I'll get everything ready.
Hey, why don't you come along too? Woohoo!
Go, Small, whiz away! I wonder what he'll see today.
Smells good in here.
Strawberries, to make strawberry jam, my favourite. First of all, the strawberries have to be put in a big pan. And then the sugar is added to make it nice and sweet. The strawberries and sugar have to be mixed together on the hob. Mmm, smells delicious. This mixture is being poured into the strawberries to help it thicken and become jam. Now the jam can be poured into jam jars and left to cool down. Lid on, and it also needs a label to tell us what sort of jam it is. This is strawberry jam, the Queen of Hearts' favourite.
Yummy strawberry jam! Better get back to the cafe. Bye!
Here we are.
Hey, good morning, Mom. How very nice to meet you, Mom. Should I call you Mom or Your Majesty, Mom? Oh, hello there, Small. I was just,
practicing your bowing?
Well, yes. Hey, I brought back some jam. Oh, wow!
Perfect. Jam fit for a queen.
I saw it being made, Ben. It was brilliant. They put all the ingredients into a big pot. Strawberries, sugar and water. And then it went all lovely and gooey.
Sounds brilliant, Small. But we better get cooking. The sooner Mom gets her jam, the better.
Right you are, Ben.
We're all ready, so take a look.
And we will show you how to cook.
Jelly boats and pirates gold, princess pea pies, carrot cakes and fruity smiles,
and envelope surprise.
We love our cafe and we love to cook. We have a fantastic recipe book.
He is big cook and he is small.
Friends in our cafe, we cook for them all.
When your tummy gets all rumbly,
you're ready for a treat.
You can make something delicious to eat.
Have you cleaned the surfaces?
Yes. Have you washed your hands?
Yes.
All clean and ready to cook.
Do you remember the ingredients to Queen of Hearts tarts?
You do?
There was shortcrust pastry.
1 packet.
And strawberry jam.
3 tablespoons. We're using strawberry, but you can use any flavour you like.
Whoopee! Let's get started! Hee-hee! Hey, Ben, you'll need to turn the oven on first.
Right you are, Small. OK, then, over to the oven we go. I'm going to turn it on to 200 degrees Celsius, gas mark 6.
Shh! I'm going to get some jam.
Make sure you get your grown-up helper to do this bit for you, because remember, the oven is hot, hot, hot. What's next, Small?
Oh, you have to do the pastry bit next, Ben. While I have a little taste. Mmm.
OK, then, here's how we roll out the pastry. Here we go. First of all, I'm going to flour the board like this and put a little bit onto the rolling pin. There. This will stop the pastry from sticking. Pop the pastry on and roll away. Oh, and I'm going to turn it every so often. There we go.
Mmm! Wouldn't it be lovely to be king? I could eat all the jam in the world! The Queen of Hearts
she made some tarts, all on a summer's day. The knave of hearts, he stole the tarts and took them clean away.
This pastry's nice and flat now, so I'm going to take this round pastry cutter and I'm going to make two circles exactly the same. One there. And another one there. How am I doing, Small?
Great! You're doing fine, Ben. Now, what shall I call myself? Okay, King Little Cook Small. No, no, that's too long. King Cook. King Small. Oh, I don't know.
There we are. Great. Now, I've put this lot of circles onto a grease baking tray. And now, I'm going to take this heart-shaped pastry cutter. Here it is. And cut out heart shapes from the remaining lot of circles. Like this. And there's one over there. And another one. If you don't have a heart-shaped cutter, you could always get your grown-up helper to cut out a heart shape for you.
I don't feel like a king yet. Perhaps some more jam might help. Woohoo!
Now I'm going to use a bit of water for this next part. I'll brush them around this pastry circle. And this will help the heart-shaped circle to stick on top. So I'll just pick it up. Careful. And place it on top of the other circle. Great. I'll just do a few more. And now for the jam in the middle. That's funny. I'm sure there was more jam in here. Small. Small, it was you. Oh, well, it's lucky I've got some more. In here. Now we're going to put some jam inside every heart. When the jam gets hot, it'll spread out. And the last one. Brilliant. All ready for the oven. So, oven gloves on, and over we go. And remember to get your grown-up helper to do this bit for you, because the oven is hot, hot, hot. In they go for 15 minutes.
I'll set the timer for 15 minutes.
There we are. Cooked and cooled. Just popping them onto a plate. There.
They look brilliant!
Hey, perfect! Here goes. Queen of Hearts tarts coming through. There. All done.
So what do we do now? Can we play?
Not yet. Time to clean and put away!
Hooray!
Wash, wipe, scrub and clean. Make the kitchen sparkle and gleam.
My name's Ben.
And my name's Small. We've got the cleanest kitchen of all.
Tidy all the bits and bobs, the things that help us do our job.
Ingredients we'll put away,
ready for use another day.
Pots and pans will start to smell
if we don't wash them really well.
And now it's clear, let's all smile, we'll be finished in a little while.
All around, up and down,
we've got the cleanest cafe in town.
Aha, here comes the plate.
Oh, yes. It looks like the Queen of Hearts enjoyed her tarts. And look, Small. She's left a note.
Well, what does it say? What does it say?
Let's see, shall we? It says, Dear Big Cook Ben and Little Cook Small, my Queen of Hearts tarts were delicious. Ooh. To say thank you, here's a little gift for my friend Small, who introduced me to jam in the first place. I wonder what it is. Here you go, Small.
Thanks, Ben. Wow! A crown for me! Brilliant!
Oh, it really suits you, Small.
Now I feel like a real king. King of the kitchen. See you soon.
See you soon.
Big cook, little cook, welcome to our cafe. Big cook, little cook, want you to come and play. Meeting all the friends we cook for, sharing stories, trips and fun. Big cook, little cook, we'll cook for everyone.
Do, 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 do. Oh, hello. Welcome to our cafe, the best cafe in the world. Did you hear that? That funny noise? Hello, everyone. Ben, what have you got on? Are you going swimming?
Swimming? What? This is for swimming. Oh, no. I found all this stuff in the dressing up box. I was trying to dress up like a monster. But I'm not going swimming, no.
Why? What's wrong with swimming?
Well, I'm afraid of the water. I can't swim. I'm scared I might sink.
Oh, don't worry, Ben. I'll teach you to swim. It's fun.
Well, the thing is, I think I've got something really important to do later, Small. We've got a customer.
Well, we'd better get cooking, but I'm not going to forget about your swimming lesson. I'm on my way. Woohoo!
Who's in our cafe today, Small?
I'll give you a clue. She's got two flippers and she's very good at swimming.
Not a dolphin?
No, Ben. She didn't swim here. She walked.
Two flippers to swim, but she walked here?
It's a little penguin. It's Penny the penguin. Hello, Penny.
I think she's hungry.
Yes, she is a little bit hungry, but that's walk also means she's thirsty.
Now I'm even more confused.
I think it's time to look in my book.
We need a story to help us cook.
Let's take a look in Little Cook's book. Little Cook's Adventures in the Big World. Let me see. Oh, yes. My holiday to the very cold South Pole. Ooh. The first thing I saw when I got there was a really unusual looking bird. She was all brown and fluffy, with little short wings. And she didn't hop like a bird. She sort of ran. I asked her what kind of bird she was, but she didn't know. All she knew was her name, Penny. She said she couldn't even fly, and she was very lonely because there were no other birds like her, anywhere. First, I helped by making a little net and catching Penny some fish for her dinner. Then it started snowing, and poor little Penny was cold, so I looked in my holiday suitcase and found my spare coat. She wasn't hungry or cold anymore, but she was still lonely. So we set off across the ice to see if we could find Penny's friends. We searched for weeks and weeks, and Penny was growing bigger and bigger. But we still couldn't find any birds that looked like Penny. Then, one day, we came across lots and lots of beautiful king penguins. It wasn't until Penny took off her coat that she realized she had grown up. She was a king penguin too. Then it dawned on me. When I first met Penny, she had been a baby penguin. That's why her feathers had been brown and fluffy. The other penguins were very proud of her. They taught her how to fish, so she wasn't hungry. She had grown up feathers, so she wasn't cold anymore.
and with all her new friends, she definitely wasn't lonely. Little Cook to the rescue once again!
That was a great adventure.
What an amazing story. And it's given me a really good idea.
Way! What's that, Ben?
Why, fish, of course.
Well, we haven't got any, Ben.
Oh, haven't we?
But penguins eat fish all the time. I think it would be really nice to cook something else for her.
OK, what though?
I don't know.
What could it be?
Ooh.
We can... Oh.
I know! Big Cook's Big Cookery Book!
Of course, the Big Cookery Book. There's recipes for everything in there.
And where do we look for things to cook?
In the book. In the book. In Big Cook's book.
Look at this one, Ben.
Iceberg slosh.
Penny the Penguin will feel right at home. There are loads of icebergs where penguins live.
Iceberg slush it is then. Come on, Small, you read out the ingredients and I'll see if we've got them.
OK, let's see. We're going to need fruit.
OK, over we go. In the fridge. Fruit, strawberries, raspberries.
Orange juice.
Orange juice. Got it.
Lemonade.
Oh, lovely fizzy lemonade, yeah.
Lemon.
Over in the fruit bowl, got the lemon.
Sugar.
Yep, sugar.
And water.
I can get that from the tap. There we are. Everything we need for the recipe. It's called iceberg slush, but where do we get the ice from?
We made that ourselves in the freezer, Ben.
Oh, yeah, silly me.
I've just remembered something. Did you know you can make models out of ice? They're called sculptures.
Really? How do you do that?
I don't know.
Hey, why don't you whiz off and find out, and I'll get everything ready.
That's a great idea, Ben. I'll be back in a jiffy. Woohoo! Hey, why don't you come along too?
Go, Small, go, Small, whiz away. I wonder what he'll see today.
It's really cold here.
Oh, no wonder it's cold. That's a big block of ice. Ice is made from water that has been put into a freezer. Because it's so cold in the freezer, the water turns into ice. Ooh, he's going to use his tools to turn the ice into a shape. Can you guess what it's going to be? It's got a head and a beak. Oh, that tool is being used to mark its wing. I think it's going to be a bird that lives in the cold. Can you guess? The bird needs to have two eyes. That's one. And that's two. Oh, look, it's a penguin. A penguin that lives in the cold.
I'd better get back to the warm cafe.
Way! I'm back! Hello there. Did you see the ice being carved?
I certainly did. It was fantastic. First they froze some water into a big block of ice. And then they carved it into a shape of a penguin, just like Penny.
Sounds amazing. Did you bring some ice back for me?
Yes, I did, Ben. Now, where is it? I put it in my pocket. Oh.
Oh, what?
Here it is.
But that's just a handkerchief, Small.
Yes, but
The ice has melted, Ben.
Oh, never mind, Small. Let's make some iceberg slush for Penny the Penguin.
Let's get cooking.
We're all ready, so take a look.
And we will show you how to cook.
The jelly boats and pirates go, Princess Pea Pies. Carrot cakes and fruity smiles.
And envelope surprise.
We love our cafe and we love to cook. We have a fantastic recipe book.
He is big cook and he is small.
Friends in our cafe, we cook for them all.
When your tummy gets all rumbly,
you're ready for a treat. You can make something delicious to eat.
Have you cleaned the surfaces?
Yes. Have you washed your hands?
Yes.
All clean and ready to cook.
Do you remember the ingredients to iceberg slush?
You do?
There were strawberries.
Three, chopped.
Raspberries.
A handful.
Orange juice.
One cup.
Lemonade.
One cup.
Lemon.
A quarter.
Sugar.
Two tablespoons.
And water.
Plenty of water for our ice cubes.
Whoopee! Let's get started!
For this recipe, we don't need the cooker. We do all our cooking in the freezer.
Yes, instead of cooking, we're freezing.
Hey, we'll need two ice cube trays. Here we are. Oh, look, Small. This one's still got an ice cube in it.
Oh, careful, Ben.
Oh, sorry, Small. Now, into one of these ice cube trays, I'm going to pour the orange juice. And I've already put it from the cup into a small jug to make it easier to pour. So, in we go. All the way along. And pop them straight into the freezer. Over we go. There we are. And make sure you get your grown-up helper to do this bit for you because the freezer is cold, cold, cold. Soon, we'll have orange juice ice cubes. What do you think of that, Small?
That was great! Oh!
Now, in this next ice cube tray, I'm going to start to make the fruit ice cubes. So, I'll put the raspberries along here. In they go. Very nice. Oh, this is going to be very fruity. There we go. That should do. And I'll put the strawberries along the other side. Nice and chopped up, so I can put a few in each. There we go.
Wow!
And that one. Great. And then we can top them up with the water. So the same again. Fill them up all the way along. Brilliant! And then straight into the freezer with these as well.
This ice cube's really slidey!
Whilst we're waiting for the ice cubes to freeze, we can prepare the cup. So, I'm going to take the lemon and wipe it all the way around the rim of this cup. There it goes. All the way around to make it all wet and sticky. That's very good. And then we can take the sugar and pour it out onto a plate. There it is. Great. Then we can turn the cup upside down and dip the rim into the sugar. Give it a bit of a twist. And hey presto, it sticks. Clever or what, Small?
I'm a penguin.
I wonder if the ice cubes are ready yet. They take a while to freeze. Oh, I know. I'll pretend to be asleep so that the water thinks it's frozen.
Good idea, Small.
Here goes. Is it morning yet?
Okay, Freezer. We've been asleep for ages now. The ice cubes must be ready.
Hooray! There we are. Absolutely perfect.
Wow, that's amazing, Ben.
It's just a little trick, Small. Huh? I put some in the freezer earlier whilst you were watching the ice sculptures so that they'd be ready in time.
OK, I'll let you off then, but I'm not going to let you off your swimming lesson, Ben.
Oh, it was only a bit of fun. Anyway, let's get on with the iceberg slush. In fact, this is the slushy part. I'm going to tip all of the orange juice ice cubes into a plastic jug or something else that won't break. So, in we go. Be very careful. There we go. And this is the fun part. I'm going to slush them up with the end of this rolling pin. Ooh. Give them a good old slush.
Penguins like ice. They must be great at skating. Woohoo!
There. That's the orange all slushy. Now, we can put it into the cup. So, I'm going to scoop it in with a spoon. That's one. And a little more, I think. There we go. And next, it's time for our fruity ice cubes. So, I'm going to take one strawberry and I think one raspberry. Yeah, there we go. And finally, we can top it off with the lovely fizzy lemonade. Now, I need to be careful not to spill it here, so I'm going to put it into a plastic jug. There we go. This should make it easier to pour. So, let's top it up now. In goes the lemonade. This is looking great. Perfect. And I'd like to finish it off with an umbrella and a straw. And if you want to, you can pop some orange on there. I love oranges. And hey presto, iceberg slush. What do you think, Small?
That looks great, Ben. Let's get it off to Penny the Penguin before it melts.
One iceberg slush coming through.
So what do we do now? Can we play?
Not yet. Time to clean and put away.
Hooray!
Wash, wipe, scrub and clean. Make the kitchen sparkle and gleam.
My name's Ben.
And my name's Small.
We've got the cleanest kitchen of all.
Tidy all the bits and bobs, the things that help us do our job.
Ingredients well put away,
ready for use another day.
Pots and pans will start to smell
if we don't wash them really well.
And now it's clear, let's all smile, we'll be finished in a little while.
All around, up and down,
we've got the cleanest cafe in town.
Aha, here comes the plate.
Oh, yes. And look, Small. There's a note.
Well, what does it say? What does it say?
Let's see, shall we? It says, Dear Big Cook Ben and Little Cook Small, my iceberg slush was delicious.
Woohoo!
Here's a present to say thank you. They helped me learn to swim. Maybe they'll help you too.
They're swimming armbands, Ben.
Now I'm looking forward to my swimming lesson. I won't sink in these. I'll swim just like a penguin. Come on, Small. Let's go. See you soon.
Hey, see you soon.
Hey.
Big cook, little cook, welcome to our cafe. Big cook, little cook, want you to come and play.
Hello. Welcome to our cafe. The best cafe in the world. I've just been cutting the grass
But it's going to take forever because the lawnmower's broken and I can't find Small. Have you seen him? Small? Small? Hey, why don't you shout with me? One, two, three, Small! Oh, I can't find Small. I think he's lost.
Whoa. Oh, hello, Ben. What's the matter?
Oh, there you are. I was worried. Whatever are you doing?
Oh, I'm just having a bit of a rest after all that grass cutting.
All that grass cutting?
Oh, yes. Look.
One blade of grass. Is that all you've done? One blade of grass?
Well, it might be one blade of grass to you, my friend, but to me it's like a tree.
We'll have a lawn up to our ears in no time at this rate.
Well, maybe you shouldn't have broken the lawnmower.
Well, I didn't break the lawnmower. It just got old. That's all, Small. Aha! Come on. Customer, Small.
I'm on my way.
And who's our customer today, Small?
You'll never guess. It's old MacDonald.
Old MacDonald?
You know Ben, the farmer from the farm down the road. He keeps chickens and pigs and the most beautiful brown horse ever.
Well, we'd better make something a bit special for him then.
Yes. But what?
Something to do with animals.
Moo! Can you guess which animal I am? A cow!
Shh, Small, I'm trying to think.
Moo! Oink, oink. Go-go-do-do-doo!
What on earth are you doing, Small?
I'm making farm animal noises, Ben. Farms are full of animals. I think it's time to look in my book.
We need a story to help us cook.
Let's take a look in Little Cook's book. Little Cook's Adventures in the Big World. Let me see.
One day I was going for a walk when I heard a lot of noise. It was a farmyard full of howling animals. They were neighing and mooing and baaing and barking and grunting and meowing. It was the most dreadful noise I had ever heard. I just had to go and find out what the problem was. The horse told me that everyone on the farm was really, really hungry because the farmer hadn't fed them that morning. Not all the animals were there, though. The chickens were missing, so I went to see if I could find them. But did I get a big surprise when I got to the chicken coop? All the hens were busy clucking and fussing round the cockerel. The poor cockerel was lying in bed looking really ill. He'd lost his voice. All he could say was, "Urk, urk, urk, urk," instead of, "Cock-a-doodle-doo!" How terrible! A cockerel without a cock-a-doodle-doo! I soon realised what the problem was. The farmer and his wife were still fast asleep. No wonder the farmer hadn't woken up. You see, it's the cockerel's job to wake the farmer up. Every day, at dawn, the cockerel stands on top of the chicken house and sings his wake-up call as loud as he can. Cock-a-doodle-doo! Cock-a-doodle-doo! Then the farmer wakes up and knows it's time to feed all the animals. But because the cockerel had lost his voice, the farmer hadn't woken up. That's when I did my famous cockerel impression. Cock-a-doodle-doo! Cock-a-doodle-doo! That soon woke them up. At last the animals would be fed. Little Cook to the rescue once again!
That was a great adventure!
Cock-a-doodle-doo!
Way! I'm back, Ben! There we go. The farmer and his wife rushed out of bed and soon they'd fed all the animals.
I bet you know exactly what to cook for old MacDonald then.
Oh, I'd forgotten about that. Let's see. It can't be that difficult. Oh, I know something that might help us. It's a song about our customer, old MacDonald.
That's sure to help us. Will you join in?
Goody, I know this one too.
Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on his farm he had some chicks, E-I-E-I-O. With a cluck cluck here and a cluck cluck there, here a cluck, there a cluck, everywhere a cluck cluck. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on his farm he had some pigs, E-I-E-I-O. With an oink oink here and an oink oink there, here a oink, there a oink, everywhere an oink oink. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O.
Oh, I love that song, Ben.
Me too.
There are so many things that come from a farm, aren't there?
Yeah, but we have to think of something for Old MacDonald in our cafe. But what?
I know, Big Cook's Big Cookery Book.
Of course, the Big Cookery Book. There's recipes for everything in there.
And where do we look for things to cook?
In the book, in the book, in Big Cook's book. Aha, uh-huh. Look, the perfect thing. Farmyard smoothies.
Mmm, milky drinks that look like animals. Whoopee!
Hooray! You read out the ingredients, little cook, and I'll see if we've got them.
Okay, let's see. We're going to need a banana.
Okay.
Banana. Honey. That's honey, not bunny, Ben.
Sorry. Honey.
Yogurt, and most important of all, milk.
Yogurt and, oh.
Are we out of milk?
I'm afraid so.
Oh, well, that scrambled our plans.
What are we going to do now, Small? We can't make smoothies without milk.
Not to worry, Ben. I'll whiz off and get some.
Oh, Small, you're the popping popcorn, and I'll get everything ready.
I'll be back in two shakes of a lamb's tail. Hey, why don't you come along too? Woo-hee!
Go, Small, whiz away! I wonder what he'll see today.
Ooh, I wonder if I'm in the right place.
Look at the lovely green grass and, oh, what's that? Something's eating the grass. It's a cow. There's lots of black and white cows. Moo, moo, moo. Here comes the farmer on his tractor. He's rounding up the cows because twice a day they have to be milked. Moo to you too! This is the milking parlour. Come on, in you go! The farmer attaches suction pipes to the cow's udders. The milk is taken from the cow. Wow, look at all that milk. The milk then goes to a factory where it's heated and cooled and put into cartons. At home, we keep milk in the fridge so it stays fresh. Milk is tasty and very good for you. I like to drink milk too, or have it on my cereal at breakfast.
I'd better get some milk back to the cafe. See you later. There's a train! Choo-choo!
There we are, all set and ready to go. All we need now is the milk.
Hey! I'm back, Ben! I've brought the milk fresh from the farm. Woohoo!
Oh, nice and creamy. Lovely. We're all ready, so take a look
and we will show you how to cook.
The jelly boats and pirates gold, princess pea pies, carrot cakes and fruity smiles,
and envelope surprise.
We love our cafe and we love to cook. We have a fantastic recipe book.
He is Big Cook and he is small.
Friends in our cafe, we cook for them all.
When your tummy
gets all rumbly,
you're ready for a treat.
You can make something delicious to eat.
Have you cleaned the surfaces?
Yes. Have you washed your hands?
Yes.
All clean and ready to cook.
Do you remember what we need for farmyard smoothies?
You do?
There was a banana.
One sliced.
Honey.
One teaspoon.
Yogurt.
One tablespoon.
And last of all, milk.
One cup.
Whoopee! Let's get started.
Now mash up the banana with a fork. In it goes. There we are. Oh, mash it up. Mash, 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 mash. I like this bit. Oh, there we go. Now we're making a drink to remind old MacDonald of his farm. It's a yellow chip drink. There we go. Now we also need to make a paper head and tail for the drink. And my little chum here can take care of that.
Okie dokie!
What noises do chicks make?
I know! Cluck, cluck, cluck! Cluck, cluck, cluck!
Okay, now, to our mashed banana, we add our yogurt. In it goes. Lovely. Our honey. There we are. Make it nice and sweet. All that in. And then finally, we put in the milk. And then mix it all together to make a lovely, thick banana drink. Mix it up, mix it up. We just finished popping the rest into a glass. Oh, very nice. Doesn't that look good? Our drink's just about ready for Small's head and tail decoration. Small, how's this chick's face coming along?
That's the face done. Now for the tail.
Oh, yes, the tail. How is the tail?
Cluck, 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 cluck. I've finished and I've stuck some tape on the back. Cluck, 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 cluck.
Thank you, Small. On we go. Now I just need a straw, please, Small.
Here you go, Ben.
Oh, thank you. And there we are. One lovely chick drink. Cluck, cluck, cluck. Now, if you want to make a pink piggy smoothie, oink, 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 all you have to do is add strawberries instead of bananas.
Come on, Ben. We'd better get that chick drink off to Old MacDonald. It looks so good.
Righto. One farmyard smoothie coming through. Oh, there.
So what do we do now? Can we play?
Not yet. Time to clean up and put away.
Hooray!
Wash, wipe, scrub and clean. Make the kitchen sparkle and gleam.
My name's Ben.
And my name's Small.
We've got the cleanest kitchen of all.
Tidy all the bits and bobs, the things that help us do our jobs.
Ingredients well put away,
ready for use another day.
Pots and pans will start to smell
if we don't wash them really well.
And now it's clear, let's all smile, we'll be finished in a little while.
All around, up and down,
we've got the cleanest cafe in town.
Aha! Here comes the plate!
And what's this? Old MacDonald's left us a note, Small.
Well, what does it say? What does it say?
Let's see, shall we? It says, Dear Big Cook Ben and Little Cook Small, the best smoothie I've ever tasted.
And what brilliant heads and tails. Just like being back on the farm.
He likes it. He really likes it.
And there's something else, Small.
Well, what?
It says, I've heard you were having problems with your lawnmower, so as a little thank you, I've left you something to cut the grass for you.
Something to cut the grass? A lawnmower?
Oh, my Small. Old MacDonald's left us a note and a goat.
A goat?
Look at this, Small. Her name's Alice, and she'll have your lawn looking lovely in no time. Well, mash my potatoes. If that doesn't beat everything, our very own goat. See you soon.
See you soon.
Big cook, little cook, welcome to our cafe. Big cook, little cook, want you to come and play.
Spoon and Moon!
Yeah.
Brilliant! Your go, Ben!
Okay, oh, hello. Welcome to our cafe. The best cafe in the world. We're just playing a little rhyming game. Alright, can you guess something that rhymes with... dish! Something that rhymes with dish.
Dish. Dish. Let me think. Aha, I know!
Okay, let me guess what you're thinking. You guess too. It swims. Okay, it swims in water.
You're almost there, Ben.
All right, and swims in water rhymes with dish. Swims in water rhymes with dish. Oh, I know. Do you? Is it a fish?
You're right, Ben.
Yeah, fish and dish. Fish rhymes with dish.
Okay, Ben, choose another rhyme.
Okay, something that rhymes with... small.
Small.
Yeah.
Oh! Small! tall. Tall rhymes with small.
Yeah!
Small and tall.
We're really good at this game, Small. Oh, here we go. There's a customer. Come on, Small.
I'm on my way. Woohoo!
Who's our customer today, Small?
Wow, that's a surprise! Our customer rhymes with hat.
Hat. Hat. Who rhymes with hat?
They also rhyme with sat.
Hat sat.
And Matt.
Ah, I think I know who today's customer is.
Does she have whiskers and a tail?
Hat, sat, Matt. A cat. Is today's customer a cat?
That's right, Ben. It's Cassie the black cat from the bakery down the road.
I wonder what a cat would like to eat. This is a tricky one, Small.
I think it's time to look in my book.
We need a story to help us cook.
Let's take a look in Little Cook's book. Little Cook's Adventures in the Big World. Let me see.
This story is all about a baker's shop with a mouse problem. There were mice everywhere. In the jam, in the flour, in the cake tin. Mice where they should not have been. So the baker bought a large black cat called Cassie. It was her job to chase the mice away. But Cassie didn't like running, and she didn't like chasing mice. All she cared about was reading. Cassie loved books, and she read and read all day long. One day, Cassie noticed all of her books had been nibbled and chewed. Tiny teeth marks everywhere. Now, she didn't mind the mice eating all the cakes and buns, but she did mind them eating her books. It was a catastrophe. Luckily, I was passing by. I had to think of something quick. I remembered mice love cheese, even more than they love cakes. I whispered into Cassie's ear. She picked up a very large book, opened the page, and began to tell a story.
The land of cheese, she said. There is a place far, far away where everything is made of cheese. The houses are made of cheese. The trees are made of cheese. There are mountains of cheese.
Soon the mice stopped their nibbling and began to listen. Living in the land of cheese sounded even more appealing than living in a baker's shop. Eventually, one cheeky little mouse scurried up to Cassie and asked,
"Excuse me, do you know how to get to the land of cheese?"
"Of course," replied Cassie and gave the mouse directions. The mice were so excited, they all scuttled out of the door and were never seen again. Now, Cassie can happily read her books and the baker can bake his cakes. Little Cook to the rescue once again!
That was a great adventure.
And the baker doesn't have those naughty little mice nibbling away at his food all the time.
Way! Woohoo! The trouble is, we know what mice like to eat, don't we?
Cheese. Lots of cheese.
But we don't know what cats like to eat. And Cassie the cat from the bakery will be tired of all those cakes.
So what can we make for Cassie the cat? Of course, the big cookery book. There's recipes for everything in there.
And where do we look for things to cook?
In the book, in the book, in Big Cook's book.
Woohoo! Well, well, look at this.
Fishy on a dishy. Do cats like fish?
Oh, they love fish, Ben.
Then let's get cooking. You read out the ingredients, little cook, and I'll see if we've got them.
Okay, let's see. We're going to need puff pastry.
Puff pastry in the fridge. Okay. Pastry, yep, got that.
One egg.
One egg, yes, got that as well.
Butter.
Butter in the fridge.
Yep. Milk.
Milk again in the fridge.
Flour.
Flour, okay. Got the flour, yep.
One tin of tuna.
One tin of tuna. There we are, lovely.
And mange tout or green beans.
Mange tout. Oh, I can get that from the garden. So, we've got mange tout in the garden, but fish. Now, I know fish live in the sea, but I can't exactly just go and pick a fish out of the sea, can I?
Well, of course not, Ben. Fishermen catch fish in... What do fishermen catch fish in?
Ooh. I'll tell you what, Small, why don't you whiz off and find out, and I'll get all the ingredients ready.
Good idea, Ben. I'll see you later. Hey, why don't you come along too?
Whoosh! Woohoo!
Go, Small! Go, Small! Whiz away! I wonder what he'll see today.
There's a train! Choo-choo!
The right place.
That's a fishing boat. Fishermen sail their boats out to sea and catch fish in the nets. When the boats are full of fish, the fishermen sail back to harbour to unload. The fish are in those crates covered with ice to keep them fresh. Now the fish are taken away to be sold to fishmongers. Look at all the crates of fish! Fish come in all different shapes, sizes, and colours. This man is selling the fish to all the fishmongers who sell the fish in their shops.
450 then. 450 by iceberg. 16. 450 iceberg.
Cats love fish.
Better get back to the cafe. See you later.
Lovely freshly picked mange too, straight from Big Cook's garden. That looks delicious.
Whee! Yoo-hoo, Big Cook Ben!
Oh, hello there. You made me jump then. Everything's ready. Did you have a good trip?
Oh, it was great, Big Cook Ben. I saw all the fishing boats collect all the fish, and then I went to a fish market where I saw even more fish.
Oh, then we better get cooking. Cassie the cat will be getting really hungry by now. We're all ready, so take a look.
And we will show you how to cook.
Jelly boats and pirates gold, princess pea pies, carrot cakes and fruity smiles,
and envelope surprise.
We love our cafe and we love to cook. We have a fantastic recipe book.
He is Big Cook and he is Small.
Friends in our cafe, we cook for them all.
When your tummy gets all rumbly,
you're ready for a treat.
You can make something delicious to eat.
Have you cleaned the surfaces?
Yes. Have you washed your hands?
Yes.
All clean and ready to cook.
Do you remember the ingredients to fishy on a dishy?
You do?
There was puff pastry.
One packet.
Egg.
One egg.
Butter.
One tablespoon.
Milk.
Half a cup.
Flour.
Two tablespoons.
Tuna.
One tin.
And mange two or green beans.
Just a few.
Whoopee! Let's get started!
First things first, I'm going to put the oven on to 220 degrees Celsius, gas mark 7. Make sure you get your grown-up helper to do that bit for you, because the oven is hot, hot, hot. Right, Small, can you get your crayon out for me? I think we need a fish shape.
Great! I might be small, but I'm brilliant at drawing. One fish shape coming up.
And I'll roll out this puff pastry. Bit of flour here.
Oi, oi! That's going all over me!
Oops, sorry.
Oh! And all over my fish shape!
Oh, well, that looks great, little cook. I'll cut out your fish shape if you beat the egg.
Right you are, Ben. Roll the egg over.
Oh, stop that egg!
Looks like the egg's beaten Small.
Phew!
Now place your fish shape onto the pastry and cut round it. This is a job for your grown-up helper to do. And you can make any shape you like. Six little fish went swimming one day over the sea and far away.
Phew! I've just broken the egg into a bowl. Now I've got to beat it. Where's my whisk? Aha!
And all the little fish came swimming back. There's the last one done. Six fish on a dish, greased with a little bit of oil. I'm just going to make one more ring on the middle of this last fish with a pastry cutter. There. You'll see what that's for later. Small, I'm going to need that beaten egg now.
There. Beaten to perfection. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Small. Now brush some egg over the pastry fish. There we are. And then we're going to pop them in the oven for 8 to 10 minutes. The egg should help them go all goldeny.
I'll set the timer. To 10 minutes. There we go.
In they go. Now it's time for the fishy filling.
There
we are. Melt the butter into a saucepan and then add the flour. Now stir it round with a wooden spoon. There we are, keep stirring. And now I'm going to add half a cup of milk. Really carefully.
Don't forget to tell them to keep on stirring so it doesn't go all lumpy.
Keep stirring so it doesn't go all lumpy. Add your tuna. There we are. Mix it in. And then take it off the heat.
Oh. By now the pastry fishes should be cooked. They're ready, big cook.
Wow, they look great.
Brilliant. We just need to wait for them to cool down. They're cool, they're cool.
Take the middle out of the fish. There we are. Oh, careful. And fill the hole with the fishy filling. There we go. That's one, and two. Lovely.
The fish are on a dish.
Oh, that rhymes. Fish and dish. Fish on a dish.
Now place the mange too around the plate to look like seaweed.
Oh, yes. Good idea. There we go.
Big cook and little cook's fishy on a dishy.
Ha ha, fishy on a dishy coming through.
So what do we do now? Can we play?
Not yet, Small. Time to clean up and put away.
Yippee!
Wash, wipe, scrub and clean. Make the kitchen sparkle and gleam.
My name's Ben.
And my name's Small.
We've got the cleanest kitchen of all.
Tidy all the bits.
bits and bobs, the things that help us do our job. Ingredients we'll put away, ready for use another day. Pots and pans will start to smell if we don't wash them really well. And now it's clear, let's all smile, we'll be finished in a little while. All around, up and down, we've got the cleanest cafe in town.
Look, here comes the plate.
Oh, yeah. And it looks like Cassie the cat enjoyed her fishy on a dishy. And she's left us a book and a note.
What does it say? What does it say?
Let's see. Let's look. It says, Dear Big Cook Ben and Little Cook Small, thank you for my fishy on a dishy. It was perfect. Perfect. I thought you might like this book of rhymes.
A book of rhymes? Brilliant!
Oh, Small, now we can play our rhyming game all the time.
So it's a book for a cook.
Yeah. A book
for a cook. See you soon.
See you soon. Okay, let's see. We've got cat and hat.
Cat and mat.
Big cook, little cook.